Now, you can listen to Wine and Dine Radio while shopping at the grocery store or your neighborhood wine merchant. Wine and Dine Radio can be heard using your wireless internet on your cell phone.
You're listening to iWine Radio. iWine Radio is a production of Food Tastes Better with Wine on the web at iWineRadio.com.
Hey guys, I thank you for listening to iWine Radio, and we are still the only wine channel on iTunes Radio. If you go look under iTunes Radio icon and scroll down to News and Talk directory, and it's listed alphabetically, click on that and the stream comes up immediately. iWineRadio.com, where you can find links to individual guests. And if anyone's interested in advertising or becoming an underwriter or sponsor, please contact us at iWineRadio.com. We really, really appreciate your support. The more support we get, the more conversations I can have with fascinating people around the world, including you. If you have a story to tell that you'd like to share on iWineRadio, go to iWineRadio.com and contact us, and we'll go from there.
Hello, my name is Wendy Eaches, Executive Administrator at the Madeira Vintners Association. We invite you to attend the Madeira Wine Trail's Wine and Chocolate Weekend, February 9th and 10th, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Tickets are available in advance for $25. Tickets are valid all weekend. And you can find more information at MadeiraWineTrail.com or call 800-613-0709.
You know, in preparation for Valentine's Day, the Madeira Vintners Association is rolling out their Wine and Chocolate Weekend on the Madeira Wine Trail. Many, many wineries are participating. The event is going to be held February 9th through the 10th from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. And you can buy your ticket in advance online. We'll tell you how you can do that. And joining us today to give us all the lowdown so you can plan that weekend is Wendy Eaches, who's the Executive Administrator of Madeira Vintners Association. And Wendy, as I understand that, actually a comment that that somebody made that I was just talking to is that Madeira is it's not a huge tourist destination, or is that wrong? I mean, because it's kind of like it's off the beaten path a little bit, right or no?
Well, yeah, I wouldn't say it's a huge tourist destination, Madeira itself, but in a way, it sort of is, because reason being, it's the gateway. It's known as the gateway to Yosemite. So everyone's passing through. And the great thing is Madeira is now there's more and more to do, especially the Madeira Wine Trail. As our wineries, we're gaining more wineries in the association. This wine region is growing, and it's one of the oldest wine regions in California. So in a way, it is a tourist destination, because everyone stops here on their way to Yosemite, and so we're becoming known for our wine and other things that are in the valley as well.
Well, that makes total sense now in my head. Gateway to Yosemite, and Yosemite gets probably millions of visitors every year.
Millions, and we're grateful to have such a beautiful destination spot like Yosemite, world-renowned, and the tourists that come through. It's really, really neat to see everyone coming through. A lot of the locals, I think, sometimes even take it for granted what we have here, and they realize, wow, look at what we have. We have all of these tourists that come through and just love it, and so we're really gaining attention lately, I think, more wineries than ever before, and so it's a great thing.
So to give us, you know, somebody listening to this in other parts of the world, not even the United States, give us a little bit of a picture before we give all the details of the weekend of what does Madeira County look like? What is the, if people were driving the Madeira Wine Trail, what is the lay of the land, the topography look like?
Well, Madeira is, I would got to say, 90% ag. It's just the Central Valley, San Joaquin Valley, that's what we're known for. It's the fruit basket of the world. But Madeira County, ag. And so you're going to see vineyards and vineyards and vineyards and orchards, and just it's never-ending crops of delicious foods and produce, and but the beautiful vineyards, especially as we turn into spring. This February event is beautiful, but as we get into our May event as well, it's just beautiful green vineyards, and then you get into the rolling hills on your way up to Yosemite, and we've got three wineries up that way in the rolling hills, and there's vineyards up there, and it's just really, really neat to see just how it's kind of a fresh breath of air as you're driving through. So that's what you'll see. You'll see a small town. There's a small town, city of Madeira, but you're going to see miles and miles and miles of crops and agriculture.
Wendy, are there very many bed and breakfasts or small quaint hotels or something to accommodate visitors? I would think that, as you say, you know, in the off season, February, March, April, May are probably really cool times to go.
Yeah, we've got, you know, not as many per se bed and breakfasts as you might see in other areas, but we partner with several hotels. There's several chain hotels. One perfect hotel, conveniently located, is Spring Hill Suites, right off of Highway 99. It's right in the center of all of the wineries on the valley floor.
Okay.
And then, if you're driving up, so there's several other hotels right around there, right in the city of Madeira. And if you branch out, and as I said, going up into the foothills and going up to the three wineries up that way on the way to Yosemite, Queen's Inn is actually owned by Idle Hour Winery, same owners, one of our wineries. So Queen's Inn is a really neat, small, boutique hotel, and the winery is right on the property, and then they have a wine bar right on the property, and it's so fun. They have all of these live music Friday night or Saturday night events, and so they have their small, nice hotel there, and you can go over to the wine bar and go over to the winery for wine tasting. So they have that. That's up in Oakhurst, which is Madeira County, but it's up in the mountains.
Okay.
And then right up the same way is this beautiful estate, it's Verna's Elderberry House, and they have, world-class restaurant, a world-class chef, and their accommodations. I mean, if you go to their website, it's gorgeous. It's this this European French style, sort of Victorian, actually, estate. The rooms are just custom. It's a lot like the Madonna Inn, where it's every room is just custom made. Completely different.
Okay.
So that's up in the foothills as well. It's Berna's Elderberry House.
Okay.
So really some unique stays out here. And so, like I said, you can get affordability in something like a hotel down in the city of Madeira, or there's these boutique, really family-owned places that you can stay at as well.
Okay, so let's, if you would please, rattle off the names of the wineries that are participating in this wine and chocolate weekend.
Sure. So I will say all of the wineries that you'll find down, let's say, the valley floor, would be Birdstone Winery, Chateau Lascoiti Winery, Crew Wine Company, Ficklin Vineyards, Pacific Crest Winery, the Pagny Wines. We've got Quadi Winery, San Joaquin Wine Company, Sumner Peck Ranch Winery, and then as you make your way up into the foothills, you'll stop by Fazy Estate Winery, which is new on the wine trail, wonderful Syrah wine, beautiful property, and then you'll keep going, and you'll run into Westbrook Wine Farm, which really neat. He's way up in the hills, but just such a unique property and farm. It's more like a farm with vines all about, and the winemaker owner is just so knowledgeable. He'll have a full conversation about with you about his wine and how it's done. And then if you keep going up, the last winery you'll get to is, like I said, Idle Hour Winery in Oakhurst. Okay. And that's the winery that has the hotel on site as well. So that's all 12. So it's quite, as far as the event goes, you've got a full weekend. If you split it up between Saturday and Sunday, your day is full if you want to make it to all 12.
And every winery is going to be approaching this concept of chocolate different. I mean, are they cooking with chocolate? Are they serving pieces of chocolate with their wine? Is everyone has a different take on it?
Yes, I was going to say that. It's a different take. You're going to see many different things all over, which everyone seems to like. I think everyone likes to see something different at each spot. Some will have, for example, I know this isn't exactly chocolate, but Ficklin Vineyards, they're going to have a cupcake truck with these chocolate cupcakes, and they're port filled with their wine.
Oh my gosh!
Port filled cupcakes. They'll also have chocolate. A lot of vendors are being brought in and doing, like San Joaquin Wine Company will have biscotti chocolate, and so these wineries are sort of, they're finding chocolatiers that can make something that complements their wines. So that's why you'll find something different at each winery, because these chocolates being brought in, they're trying to find something that really complements their wines. So, gosh, everything, chocolate truffles, chocolate-covered strawberries are at Chateau Lascoiti. It's just, you'll find it all. It's all out there.
You'll be in chocolate and red wine heaven.
Oh, gosh, yes. I think, I've got to say this event is probably the most popular event. If you've been out there before, you know the crowd. The crowds aren't bad, but especially spread upon 12 wineries, you're not going to see crowds, but I think everyone knows this event is just a hit because of Valentine's Day. It's such a unique way to celebrate Valentine's Day with your loved one or friends, and so it's just perfect. It's just a unique way to go have fun that weekend.
Wow. I wish I didn't live so far away.
I know. We need to bring it your way.
You know what? There is a way that people can make this work at home, and that is if they purchase wines from these wineries and they have chocolate, they could basically be kind of reproducing a Madeira Wine Trail Wine and Chocolate Weekend as a party, as an excuse for a party with friends.
Right. Well, of course, we always love visits from everyone. We hope everyone comes out to visit us, but the winemakers are happy to take your orders by phone or over the email, ship you some wine, and you can have it right in your home.
There we go. Good. We had to get that in because not everybody can be out there for the Wine and Chocolate Weekend on the Madeira Wine Trail. Wendy Eaches, thank you so very much for joining us today representing the Madeira Vintners Association.
Thank you, Lynn.
We will have links up for you to learn more. If you're a chocoholic like me, this sounds like a perfect way to spend a weekend. You're listening to Wine and Dine.
Now, you can listen to Wine and Dine Radio while shopping at the grocery store or your neighborhood wine merchant. Wine and Dine Radio can be heard using your wireless internet on your cell phone.
You're listening to iWine Radio. iWine Radio is a production of Food Tastes Better with Wine on the web at iWineRadio.com.
Hey guys, I thank you for listening to iWine Radio, and we are still the only wine channel on iTunes Radio. If you go look under iTunes Radio icon and scroll down to News and Talk directory, and it's listed alphabetically, click on that and the stream comes up immediately.
iwineradio.com, where you can find links to individual guests. And if anyone's interested in advertising or becoming an underwriter or sponsor, please contact us at iwineradio.com. We really, really appreciate your support. The more support we get, the more conversations I can have with fascinating people around the world, including you. If you have a story to tell that you'd like to share on iWine Radio, go to iWineRadio.com and contact us, and we'll go from there.